Check this out, gang. I've never felt so safe walking in an attic. Got a catwalk with aisle lighting and even an approved handrail.
Nice, man.
Hit the lights, bud. Let's see this thing in the dark.
Oh!
Look at that. Nice.
What?
Hey, gang. Welcome back to the channel.
Come on.
Hey, gang. I'm Paul with Stud Pack. Welcome back to our channel. In our previous video where we talked about getting ready for the electrician, we had a lot of comments about the boxes we were using and the knockout on the back. A lot of you said, that's not a knockout, that's a clamp. So let's try to settle this, gang. I've got three Carlon boxes right here on the table. Let's check it out. This is the one you were all commenting about, the one we were installing. This is an adjustable depth box from Carlon, the kind we use for our backsplashes. And this is just a two gang box, nail on. On this one, it's got this little, I'm gonna call it a knockout, and you can call it a clamp if you want, but it's right there. And it's got these two ridges on either side, and it's attached to the box by two little pieces of plastic, which allows it to hinge. So you can take a piece of Romex, this is a piece of 14-2, you can push it in one side, and it does grab the wire. My problem is, when you put another one in, now it pivots to the middle, and neither one of these is being anchored by that. Now, regardless of whether you call that a clamp or a knockout, you still have to staple this within 8 inches of the box, so it's kind of a moot point. But let's go on to this one. It's got kind of the same little knockout, but this one is smooth. It doesn't have these two ridges, and it's attached to the box at 4 points. So that is obviously a knockout. So how can that be a knockout, but that be a clamp? It's kind of interesting. And on this one, we all would agree, I hope we all agree, that that is an integral clamp. Just like that. That's the intended purpose, and that's what it's for. So I actually emailed Carlon about this. I don't expect to hear from him. If any guys know anybody at Carlon, hit them up, tell them, hey, you need to figure this out for Stud Pack. We'd appreciate it. But enough about these boxes. Let me show you over here in this wall about one I found yesterday. So when I demoed this circuit here, and we made it up in a junction box in the attic, because that's gonna be covered by a piece of furniture, I could see a piece of Romex coming down this wall. I knew it wasn't this one that's feeding the dryer because I had that circuit off and the dryer had power. So I had to remove this drywall anyway because we have some plumbing repairs to do. And when you know it, I found a buried junction box right here, completely covered by the drywall. And to make it worse, the wires were hot and they didn't even have wire nuts on them. I put those on. So I think every house must have at least one buried junction box, don't you think?
I think so.
All right. So enough about electrical boxes. Let's go over here and show you today's project. So gang, you know, when you do a renovation, there are days when there is massive progress. Walls are coming down, beams are going up, drywall's being torn down, floors are being ripped out. But there's other days where you're like, yeah, what happened today? Well, that's kind of where we're at. Our electrician was here yesterday. We're waiting on him for a bid on replacing our panel and some other stuff, waiting on some inspections. So we thought we'd get up here in the attic and do something that's really gonna help us and future contractors get around up there. So today's task, we're gonna improve the quality of life on this job site. How many times have you been in an attic and you're like, I need to get way over there from here, and somebody has taken the time to plywood a path for you? Well, that's what we're gonna do, because it is extremely difficult to get from that side of the house where the pull down stairs are. That's what we have here. We have pull down attic stairs, no basements here. We don't know what basements are.
I've never even been in a basement.
Me either. So to get from that side of the attic to this side where we're gonna have to be running cable for our lights, hooking up our exhaust hood on the kitchen, it's hard to get to because we have to walk across this vaulted ceiling, or we have to walk across the dining room ceiling and all our roof braces are in our way. We could get way over here, but that's hard to get to because we have this other roof in our way. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna build a catwalk. And a couple of you guys have actually commented on that we should do that. We love those kind of comments. So we're gonna use some of the plywood that we found in the attic. We're gonna use some of the 2x4s from our temporary walls so we don't have to buy any material. And we're gonna build a catwalk about 20 feet long right across here. I've already started right here and it's awesome. But let me take you to the other end and show you how we do this thing. So the plywood we found in the attic is 1/2-inch roof sheathing, and I'm gonna rip it into thirds, 3 16-inch wide pieces. So it just so happens that this blade on my square is 16 inches. So I'm gonna hold it up on the beam. So when this leg of the square is flush with the rafter, right where my finger is, that tells me that this is the top of the 2x4 where our plywood is gonna sit on this side. So once I got that line established, I measured down from my line to the bottom of the beam. It was 14 and a half inches. I deducted 3.5 inches for the width of a 2x4. I come up with 11. I got two 11 inch blocks. I screw them to the beam. Then I can easily put the 2x4 on here, let it sit on here while I nail it off. That way it's perfectly straight. So let's attach these two right here and put up our last 2x4. All right, gang, we're close. Our last step, we're just gonna toe screw the 2x4 into the cathedral ceiling 2x6. Probably overkill, but it's gonna stiffen this up a lot. Now, I know this would be stronger the other direction. I just didn't wanna cut a bunch of 4-foot pieces and have them up here. And this is gonna be plenty strong. It's a little spongy, but your feet are gonna be out to the side anyway. For what it is, it's gonna be okay. All right, gang, the catwalk is almost done. This is great. I can't wait to use this thing. All we need now is an OSHA-approved handrail, maybe some aisle lighting to make it super safe. We got one thing left we want to do right here where the plywood joints are. It's a little sketchy, so we're going to go cut some blocks and attach those, and we'll be done with this catwalk. Let's go downstairs and attach those blocks. Right, those blocks made all the difference in the world right there at the seam. This thing is fantastic. It is going to save us stepping through this ceiling as we tried to walk here if we didn't have this catwalk. Check this out. It also makes a nice little place for all these wires to rest right there. This brace right here, that's for you, Dave. You know who you are. I promise you I would do it. And there it is, bud. Thanks for the support. And speaking of comments, we're going to head downstairs and do something else that you guys inspired us to do. Alrighty, gang. A few of you commented about the beam we put up and how skinny it is. Now it's only 3.5 inches wide. And your comment was we should pad it out with some 2x4s to make it fatter so that the scale of the beam is more appropriate for the space. We totally agree. So we're gonna put some 2x4s on the bottom and the top, just like you see here. We grabbed the plywood spacers that we used up top on our catwalk, screwed them to the bottom of the beam. And now the 2x4 is just sitting on there. So we got our bracket right here. We had to notch it around the screws. We're gonna show you how we did that. All that's left is to grab the framing gun and nail that thing to the beam and then do the other one. So let's get it done.
Right.
Is not the saw stop manual. All right, that beam is padded out. I can already tell it's gonna make a huge difference in the final product. You saw us build the catwalk, put that brace up, And one thing we didn't show you, I actually finished that strong back above Jordan. So that ceiling is nice and solid. So we're ready for drywall. The only thing holding us up, insulation and electric. I just got a text from my electrician. He is over 2 weeks out from helping us out on this project. I really don't want to wait that long, so I'm going to text him later here tonight, see if he can fit us in. Hopefully he has a cancellation and we can keep this project moving forward for you guys and the owners. In the meantime, we're going to keep doing what we can do. So we have a project for tomorrow. So we'll see you then. Hey gang, it's the next day. It's a perfect day in Louisiana to run some duct work. So that's what we're gonna do today while we're waiting on our electrician. So let me show you what we have here. When we did the demo, we saved this 10x7x7 splitter.
Dude, this looks like something out of the Saw movies, man. What is this?
What's a Saw movie? Is that like a horror movie?
Yeah, it's actually really, it's a great movie. A great story, you should watch it.
I'll check it out.
Yeah.
So we saved this because there's nothing wrong with it other than the fact that if you look in here, it's got some pretty big gaps. Can you see that?
Yeah.
So that's a lot of air leakage, so we're gonna seal that. So I brought it outside this morning and cleaned it just with the garden hose and a brush. Cleaned all the dust out of it so this tape would adhere. So we're gonna reinstall that, seal all the joints with our foil tape, and then our new flex duct, which I'm gonna show you. And we've got our 36-inch nylon ties here for the insulation. Here's our register boots. These things are pretty cool. I was actually at Lowe's this morning for some other stuff. They didn't have this. They have flex duct, but not in the 7-inch size. So I went around the corner to my local plumbing HVAC store. They had everything. Check these guys out. That's the real deal right there.
Nice insulated.
Yep.
Ooh.
And this is called a 12x6. That's your grill size. x7. That's your duct size. So this is a 12x6x7. You can get them 12x6x6, 12x6x8, anything. So I got three of those and 25 feet in each bag of the 7-inch flex duct. I got two bags. So I think the first thing we want to do is put this thing up right here. They're made to sit on top of these 2x6 joists. This flange right here is going to catch that joist. We're going to show you that. And I think, Jordan, I want to put it right here, huh?
Yeah, this looks good.
And that'll center it on that window.
Yeah.
So why don't we jump in the attic? I'll screw this down and we'll run this first piece of flex duct.
Sounds good.
All right. All right, let's check this out. Nice.
What?
Yep. All right, I like that location. So what I did, the middle of it here is centered 2 feet off the exterior wall. This is flush here. So I've just got some 1-inch screws, sheet metal screws that I'm gonna use and fasten it to the top of the joists. All right, cool. Let me go back underneath and check it, make sure it's still flush with the drywall. And then all we gotta do is put the flex on here, install that splitter, and get this one done.
Cool.
All right, before we install this Y, remember we're gonna fix this gap on the inside. I'm just gonna use tape, like that piece I put right there. They do make a mastic you can put here, but I don't have mastic, I do have tape. And just the tape, sealing that up, is gonna make a world of difference. So let's seal that up, and then we'll bring this up in the attic and install it. All right, cool, that's all sealed up. Let's head up there and put this piece in. So this Y has these dampers in it, and this handle is aligned with the damper, and it tells you whether it's open or closed. Now, ideally, I would like to be able to see those, but this thing's gonna work the best if it's in that direction. This one's gonna feed the kitchen, and this one will go almost straight to the dining room. So we're gonna put it that way, and they're gonna be open all the time. So we're just gonna put it like that. So let me get it on the main trunk here, and then just have some self-drilling screws on my magnetic Klein wristband. We'll put 4 in here, and then we'll put a piece of tape around it. Nice. Yeah, this is cool. I won't drop anything now. All right, aren't those scissors nice?
Yeah, what's up with the bronze?
Titanium coated, baby.
Mm.
So see the old duct tape on there?
Yeah.
And this is foil tape. We're using foil tape. That's what we're supposed to use.
Yeah, don't use duct tape on a duct.
Yeah, whoever thought of that?
Well, is that what it was for back in the day?
Probably, before they had all this modern stuff.
Right. So it might have been called duct tape early on for duct work, and then it changed, but they never changed the name.
I saw a sign on one of those, you know, those businesses that changed their signs every week to a funny sign that said, "Save the ducks, ban duct tape." D-U-C-K.
Right.
Nice. All right, why don't we open up our bag here of 7-inch flex and run that short piece right there. All right. There we go. It's warm up here, bud.
Yep.
Come over there and hook up that in. Right now I'm doing the other side. I've got this as straight as I can for maximum airflow. And I just poke through all the layers with my scissors. And I'm cutting around, and then eventually I'm gonna get to the wire that's embedded in the inner liner, and I'll have to cut it. All right, I see it. All right, so I've cut through the pink insulation and the foil liner. And then right here is the wire on the inner liner. I just cut it, and I'm done. Let's put that on the catwalk. All right, now we'll put the inner liner over it. You still got this one.
Yes, sir.
I can probably tape that. I can use a zip tie.
I would zip tie it.
Just zip tie it?
Yeah. I like the zip ties. And zip ties a lot easier to clean up in case anything else, in case anything happens. You can just cut it.
I've got a bunch of them.
Yep.
Got my damper open. Pull the insulation over. Cool. All right, there's one. Good job. Let's go ahead and hook up here with this piece and then go install that box. All right, as easy as that one was, this one's gonna be hard. So this strong back right here is in the way of where we wanna put that grill. So I'm actually gonna cut it because my desire to have the grill centered on the window is stronger than my desire to have this strong back on that last joist. I'm gonna cut it out of my way, and then I'm gonna fix it later. So I'm gonna mask up. I've got my reciprocating saw right here, and I'm gonna cut the last bit of this out of the way and see if that duct will fit there. Yeah, it's not doing much.
Nope.
I thought I would need the crowbar. Who needs a crowbar? All right, here's where we want this thing. Right back here. So Jordan's gonna hold it for me. I'm gonna go downstairs with my drywall router, route around it. I'm gonna drop it in and attach it. All right, the hole is cut. We did not use the router because we could not get this in place where we wanted it so that the router could follow this. So instead, I laid it out from downstairs and cut it with my drywall saw. First thing I did, I used this little screwdriver. Boom, boom, boom. Found the edge of the stud. Jordan confirmed it. And then this line right here, I kind of goofed. I forgot to account for this offset, but I caught it before I made the cut. So I moved my lines over, cut it out, fits perfectly. So now we're gonna go upstairs and install it, but it's kind of tight right there. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna hook up the flex duct first, like over here where we have more room, and then push the whole thing in place and screw it down, and then we're done with this side of it.
You're gonna drop it in right now?
Yep.
All right.
You wanna go downstairs and get that?
It's just gotta go to the joist.
All right, gang, we're all connected on the other end. I got the boot screwed to the framing. Now we're just gonna leave this as a 25 footer. No need to cut it. In fact, it's gonna be perfect. Now we're gonna hook it up to here, just like this other one. So actually, we're gonna cut it. It's pretty long. All right, that's this side. Now you'll notice this section right here is uninsulated. We actually have some duct to demo on the next one, so we're gonna carefully remove that blanket that's wrapped around that rigid duct. We're gonna come over here and insulate this. So don't worry about this. We're gonna make sure we get this taken care of for you. All right, bud, let's head back downstairs. I can tell it's raining outside. Sounds nice on the roof.
Yeah, maybe it'll cool down.
Yeah, and then let's get that third one in. That's our last one. All right, gang. We came downstairs, so let's talk a little bit about these grill layouts. Now, standing right here where I am, coming in the back door, And seeing this one centered on the window, I love it. Looks great. And remember, this tray where the old fluorescent lighting goes, that all goes away. So loving where that one was, and you know us, we like to line everything up, but we can't line up with that one because that strong back is right here and I don't want to cut it here. I didn't have a problem cutting it on the very end over there, but I don't want to cut it here. And here it's even worse because it has a 2x6 on each side of it. So we're going to spin the grill 90 degrees and put it this way, right here. That's going to pump air into this area. It's going to be pulled around into the return air down that hallway like we talked about. It's far enough from this table where it's not going to be blowing on you when you're eating breakfast. And then it's really going to help cool off this area because they told us that when the sun is setting, this is due west, that evening sun just pours in this window and bakes this area. So hopefully by adding that grill there, it'll cool this off. So George's going to hop up in the attic. He's going to place the boot in place where we want it. I'm going to have the drywall router down here, go around it, put it in, and run that duct.
Woo! Gotcha.
Hey, what are you doing?
Hey.
All right, push it down.
One more piece, but let's demo this. We'll attach our new flex here and go right to the new one.
Great. Got it. Coming down.
Alrighty guys, this one's done. Now I'm gonna come back later. I'm gonna hang it from right here. So it's a nice gradual bend. It's not laying up there like that. That'll be a much cleaner installation. So all we have to do now is head over here and wrap up that Y with some insulation. But we got a new idea, so let's show you what we're gonna do. So we have this piece left and one a little bit longer from the other side. All I'm gonna do, just cut the foil facing like that and see how it's going to come apart, and that'll give me two nice size blankets, so to speak, and we'll wrap all this up so it's not exposed metal. That looks sweet. And then we can fix that other one, see how it came apart. We'll get all that fixed up. And the reason I don't want to use the existing from the duct we took out of here, there's like 100 staples in that thing, and by the time I pull them all out, it's going to be shredded, and this will be much nicer. All right, that's going to be a wrap for this video. I am loving this catwalk. Is it over the top? It sure is, but that's kind of how Stud Pack does it. And look, we were having a little fun anyway, right? We had some spare pipe, some spare 2x4s, some spare LEDs, so what the heck? That looks awesome. We got all the duct run out to the perimeter of the building instead of the core of the building like it was before. The owner just came home from work, so they can tell the difference already, and we can too, even without ceilings. We can tell a difference in the room below. And each of our three runs presented a little bit of a different challenge. This one was super easy. This one was not, but that's how it goes in the construction world. But it's all done. Super happy with that. We can check that off the list. So why don't you head out to your shed, get some 2x4s and some plywood, build yourself a catwalk all the way to that like button on your monitor, smash it for us, ask us a question, leave a comment, subscribe. We would super appreciate that. And we will see you on the next one.